हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द साइंस क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू ऑल नो दैट फ्रॉम वेनसडे ऑनवर्ड्स द PA1 एग्जाम्स आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट। यस, फॉर योर साइंस सिलेबस वी आर हैविंग अ टोटल 2 लेसन्स। सो लेट अस डू द रिविजन ऑफ द फर्स्ट लेसन, मोर अबाउट प्लांट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द एग्जाम विल बी फॉर 40 मार्क्स। So you have to read, fill in the blanks, true or false, match the following, short answers, okay? These all you have to read. Whatever in your checkpoint and evaluate part is there, you have to study everything. Today, in this video class, I will do the revision of your first lesson, more about plants here. So let us see, in your checkpoint number 2, yes, there is a match the following first, okay? Let us see the match the following. The first one, poppy. Yes, what is a poppy? It is a dispersal by explosion. Yes, the poppy is an example for dispersal by explosion. Fern. Ferns are example, nothing but they will grow from a spores here. The fern plants will grow from a spores. The next one, onion. Yes, it is a grows from a stem here. Onion grows from a stem part. Dandelion, it is a dispersal by wind here. Carrot is, it will grow from the roots part here. So it is a match the following from your checkpoint number 2. So here is the fill in the blanks. Let us see the few fill in the blanks here. The part of a plant that grows below the ground is called a whether plumule or radical. Yes, below the ground it is called a radical. If the part of a plant, if it grows above the ground, then it is a plumule. Yes, okay, dear students, remember here, there are two parts are there. If the part of a plant, if it grows below the ground, okay, if it grows below the ground, then it is called a radical part. If it grows above the ground, then it is a plumule part. Remember, so here they have asked the part of a plant that grows below the ground. Below the ground is nothing but it is a radical. So the correct answer is radical. The second fill in the blanks. The scattering of seeds away from the parent plant. Okay, the scattering of seeds. The seeds will scatter from the parent plant. For that, what we are calling? We are calling a seedling or a seed dispersal. It is a seed dispersal from the parent plant, they told. If the seeds scatter from the parent plant, then it is a seed dispersal. Plants that do not bear seeds and flowers and they reproduce through their special structures called a whether the spores or cotyledons. Yes, it is a spores. Okay, the plants, some plants, they will not even bear the seeds and even they will not give a flowers also. But they will reproduce. Then how they will reproduce? They will reproduce through a special structure called a spores here. Yes, in a fern, plants have shown the spores like a holes it will be. Okay, some dots like a structures will be there. For that only we are calling here spores. Any piece of a potato with an dash can grow into a new plant. Any piece of a potato with a eye or a ear. Yes, potatoes will be having a eye. We will call that small birds will call them as a eye we are calling. So, any piece of a potato with an eye can grow into a new plant. Okay, with that eye only. Yes, potato eye will grow into a new plant here. The small white birds, for that only we are calling eye. The small birds on a potato, for that what we are calling? We are calling it as a eye. So, any piece of a potato with an eye can grow into a new plant here. Okay, let us see the next objective type questions here. It is there in your evaluate part. The first one, seeds need warmth to sprout. So would a roasted seed sprout faster? No, too much heat would harm the baby plant inside a seed. Okay, the correct answer is B option. No, too much heat would harm the baby plant inside the seeds. seed is student roasting is when the seeds will roast when you heat more. When you heat more, the seeds will roast. Till you give more heat, the seeds will not roast here. So roasted meaning here is nothing but giving more heat. But too much heat would harm the baby plants. So what the seeds need a warmth to sprout. So would a roasted seed sprout faster? No. The roasted seeds will not sprout faster here. It will harm the baby plant inside the seed here. Where does the seed get its roots and leaves from? See dear students, from where does the seed get its roots and leaves? It will get its roots and seeds leaves from its cotyledons. The correct answer is its cotyledons. Where does a seed get its roots and leaves from? The seeds gets its roots and leaves from its cotyledons. Third one, which among the following is not an agent of seed dispersal? Dear students, there are four seed agents of dispersal are there. One is a dispersal by wind, dispersal by fruit explosion, but spores is not a seed dispersal. Fruit explosion and wind are the agents of dispersal, but not a spores, remember. Okay, the next one, here they have given the unscramble the words and find the answers. Dear students, they have given one sentence and answer they have given in unscramble words, nothing but the letters they have jumbled here. You have to find it correct word. It is very important. These are very important. Okay, outer cover of a seed. Outer cover of a seed is called what? Seed coat. Crops grown in a summer. The crops which are grown in a summer are carif crops. Plants that are grown in a large quantity. Those are crops here. Plants that are grown in a large quantity are crops. The method of seed dispersal in a balsam is a explosion. It is explosion. Okay? This is about the unscramble words. Let us see the next one. Which part of the plant of the following plant will grow into a new plant? Bryophyllum. It will grow from a buds. Sweet potato. Roots. Ginger. Small buds. Chili. From seeds. Money plant. Stem. These are the part of a plant. From these only the new plant will grow. Bryophyllum will grow from a buds. Sweet potato, roots. Ginger plant will grow from a small buds. Chili also will grow from a seeds. Money plants will grow from a stem here. Let us see the short answers here. Yes, I have given already the short answers. Just I will discuss here. What is a germination? Germination is the process. It is the process by which a seed produces a baby plant. Seed will produce what here? Baby plant or seedling. In the presence of water, air and warmth. In the presence of what? Water, air and warmth. Define agriculture. What is agriculture? The practice of a growing plants. Nothing but practice of a growing plants on a large scale for a food. Way on a large scale. For what purpose? For food or other purpose is called agriculture. The practice of growing plants on a large scale for food or other purpose is called agriculture. Name three essential elements other than soil for the growth of a seed. See dear students, if a seed want to grow, then which are the essential elements? The three essential elements other than soil for the growth of a seed are air, water and warmth. These are the three elements. Air, water and warmth are the three essential elements. Okay, other than soil for the growth of a seed. If a seed want to grow, if a seed want to grow, it requires air, water and warm also, warmth. Fourth question, which special features of a potato help in growing its new plant? See dear students, the small birds, I have told na, on the potato, the small white birds will be there. Have you observed on a potato, there will be some small white color birds. So, the small birds on a potato helps in growing its new plant. From those small birds only, the new baby potato plant will grow here. So, the small birds on a potato helps in growing its new plant here. Fifth one. What is counter farming? Where and why it is done? Why counter farming is done? Let us see what is counter farming first. Counter farming is nothing, farming is nothing but cutting steep slopes into several steps and create a flat surface for growing crops. This type of farming is called counter farming. Dear students, the steep slopes, the slopes they will cut into here several steps. Yes, you know the staircase? Yes, in the same manner, in the several steps they will cut here. For what purpose they will cut? To create a flat surface. Yes, to get the flat surface, as you know the slopes, they will be up and down. To make it as a flat surface, okay, why they will make a flat surface? For growing crops. Okay, this type of farming we are calling it as a counter farming. Where and why it is done? It is done in a hilly regions. In a hilly regions, there will be slopes. So, to make it as a flat surface, what they will do? They will make a counter farming. Because people do not get enough flat surface, flat space to grow crops. Because the people will not get a flat surface. So, they will follow counter farming. Okay. Explain the parts of a seed using a diagram. Yes, dear students, you know the diagram. It is there in your page number 204. It is very important. Remember. Okay. IMP means important. You have to practice the diagram of this dicot seed and monocot seed. And you have to write these parts here. Seed coat, seed leaves, embryo. These are the parts of a seed here. Yes, this is the embryo part. And this is the leaf, seed leaves. Yes, whatever inside are they, these are the seed leaves. And outside covering is a seed coat. Let us explain it one by one. Seed coat. The seed leaf, seeds have a hard covering called a seed coat. The seeds are having here the hard outer covering. For that we are calling it as a seed coat. Seed leaves. The seed leaves inside a seed are called a cotyledons. Whatever the seed leaves are there, inside that seeds are there, for that we are calling it as a cotyledons. Embryo. The baby plant inside a seed is called a embryo. Can you see the baby plant here inside the seed? This is a embryo. So what is an embryo? The baby plant inside a seed is called a embryo. Okay, this is the diagram of a dicot seed and monocot seed. Dear students, you have to practice both dicot and monocot, and you have to practice the parts of a seed also. It is very important. Let us see the next one. Define crops. Name two main types of crops grown in India. Okay, the definition of a crops. The large amount of grains, fruits and vegetables grown by a farmer in a particular season at a particular place is called a crop. What is a crops? The crops are nothing but large amount of grains, fruits and vegetables. These whatever grains, fruits and vegetables are there, who will grow? These will be grown by a farmer. Where? In a particular place and in one particular season. For that only we are calling it as a crop. There are two main types of crops are there grown in India. Which are those? Rabi crops and kharif crops. These are the two main types of crops. Rabi crops and kharif crops. Next one. Define harvesting and irrigation. Harvesting means what? It is the process of gathering ripe crop from a field. Harvesting means what they will do? They will harvest. It is one of the process of a gathering a ripe crop from the field. Nothing but if it grows fully ripe, when it ripes, they will collect it. For that harvesting we call. Irrigation is the process of supply of water to the field through the pipes and channels. In a irrigation, what they will do? They will supply the water here. Differentiate between monocot seed and a dicot seed. Monocot seed, dicot seed. Seed with a one cotyledon is called a monocot seed. Seed with a only one cotyledon is there means monocot. Seed with a two cotyledons is called a dicot seed. Example, corn seed. For dicot seed example, kidney beans. Dear student, this difference is also very important. Study it properly. Okay, what are pesticides? A chemical sprayed to the crops to protect from a pest. What are pesticides? It is a chemical sprayed to the crops here. Why they will spray these pesticides? To protect from a pest like a mice and all. Okay, to protect from that pest, they will spray the pesticides to the crops here. These are the short answers I have discussed. From this lesson, I have discussed everything. So now it's the time to study. So dear students, study for your exam. Have a nice day. Thank you.